Hi guys, welcome back to Sleeve Saturday. So this week I got to sit down and interview the rock icon, Jim Peterick. Jim, of course, is the founder of the Ides of March, and of course, formerly of Survivor. You know me, I try to ask the questions that the fans want to hear. All this week, I'll be releasing several clips of our interview, you know, as a little teaser. The full interview will be released next weekend. Enjoy.
And that's when we started holding auditions, and there's a lot of very terrible singers who flew in from different places.
Yes.
And like, oh God, what do we tell this guy? Well, thank you. You know, see ya. Anyway, and then we heard a great singer named Kevin Chalfant, who of course was in The Storm. Yeah, great band, and had his own solo career. And we were just about to say yes to Kevin. And the next day, a very humble Southern guy named Jimmy Jameson flew in, and the rest is history. And we were just, Frankie and I had just finished a new song, Broken Promises. And we showed him Broken Promises, and he picked it up so quick. I said, dude, have you heard this song before? That's how good his ear was. And how good his voice was. We had this shitty PA. He made it sound like $1 million because his voice was so clear and so loud.
Mm.
And there was absolutely no transition between his chest voice and his high register.
Yeah.
It's not like falsetto. Like some guys go, ooh. He just kept going.
Yeah.
Best singer I ever worked with.
There you stood, battle teacher.
He was unbelievable, and you've kind of preempted it, because I have the album behind me, Vital Signs. It's in my top five, maybe top three favorite albums of all time. I was going to ask you what the first time you heard Jimmy sing, but you've kind of answered that. Look, there's too many deep tracks to even go in. We need a whole day, you know. I Can't Hold Back, High on You, First Night, Search Is Over, iconic, and Popular Girl, which I adore. Popular Girl, it's such a great tune. My question is though, did you write differently? I know you had some of the songs already written, but did you write differently for Jimmy than you did Dave? Would Vital Signs have been a different record had Dave still been there?
Good question, and definitely. I always write for voices. Now, of course, you know, we already had a few songs that I was thinking, it's not going to be Dave, but I really want to find a guy that could really get up there. When Jimmy auditioned, I had songs that were tailor-made for him, like Broken Promises, like The Search Is Over.
Yes.
I hadn't finished it yet, but Frankie and I polished it up in the next couple days, taught it to him, and I still get goosebumps hearing that song the first time he sang it. And then flash forward to the studio when Ron Nevison was producing again, thank God. And he, what a great producer. And I was in the control room, Frankie was in the control room, and he sings The Search Is Over. And I was in tears, you know? And that's what Jimmy's voice could bring out of a person, and still does.
Agreed. He's just so iconic, and he's so well loved by the AOR, melodic rock, arena rock community. There's just such a love for him. And
the search is over. Love was right before.